always from the heart of the city, and now on demand 24/7 on the CHFI website. This is the soundtrack to accompany some wedding nightmares. And I'm Don Jackson with lovers and other strangers around the world on the internet. If you're going to be married this year, have you been having some rather unsettling dreams? If you think back to the months and days before your wedding, if you're already married, did you find your sleep disturbed by some rather persistent and disturbing nightmares? Some real-life wedding nightmares this hour, and what they might mean for lovers and other strangers. From CHFI.com. Amanda Marshall and Marry Me, and Share with Peter Cetera, After All. Lovers and other strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. I think each and every one of us has nightmares leading up to the wedding day. It may be nothing more than your mind trying to deal with the stress of all the planning that you have to take care of when you're awake. These dreams could manifest as getting lost and frustrated trying to find the church, or as that recent TV commercial that showed the bride waiting at the front of the church and her groom arriving late in a powder blue tuxedo that looks too short in the sleeves. Truthfully, though, I don't remember if I dreamed any unsettling dreams before my wife and I were married. I asked her recently whether she had any, but she couldn't recall either. But that doesn't mean we both never dreamed of things going awry on our special day. We may just have forgotten them. Most of these dreams are frustrating in the sense that we come up against all kinds of crazy delays. Maybe the photographer shows up with no film in his camera. The wedding dress isn't the one you ordered or doesn't fit. The tux arrives and, you guessed it, it's powder blue. But there are people whose dreams of their wedding have left an indelible impression on their minds. You'll meet them this hour, and we'll peer into their nightmares. With lovers and other strangers. From CHFI.com. John Lennon, Just Like Starting Over, and Tracy Chapman, In a Fast Car. Lovers and other strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. This hour, some excerpts from another short piece that appeared in a past issue of Glamour magazine's Private Time column. This writer begins, and I quote, "Many engaged couples have recurring nightmares about the upcoming event. Leslie, who wanted a really posh wedding, dreamed that her jazz ensemble canceled and the replacement band only played covers of Eagles songs. Barry, a groom-to-be, dreamed that he was trying to walk down the aisle. But when I looked down, he remembered, I didn't have any feet. According to UCLA psychologist Mark Schoen, PhD, who specializes in dream therapy, there are two kinds of dreams. Situational dreams, in which your mind processes the day's events, and personality dreams, which reflect emotional issues. Dreams about wedding details going awry are situational. They tend to happen to anyone handling the wedding planning, says Sean. But personality dreams do seem to have a gender difference." Unquote. And more about that difference shortly with lovers and other strangers from CHFI.com. Lovers and Other Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Shania Twain with Brian White from This Moment, Brian Adams and I'm Ready, and The Eagles with The Best of My Love. Again, according to UCLA psychologist Mark Schoen, PhD, a specialist in dream therapy, and again I quote, women's wedding dreams usually relate to trust and safety. They may dream about being stood up at the altar, says Schoen. Men's dreams are usually about commitment and vulnerability. Many male clients dream that they're walking down the aisle naked, which shows a fear of being exposed and rejected. Unquote. Lovers and Author Strangers from CHFI.com. Lovers and Author Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Rihanna, Take a Bow, and Leanne Rimes, and How Do I Live Without You? The writers of this Glamour magazine article go on to say, and again I quote, recurring dreams can be a wedding gift. They help you confront your marriage fears. I dreamed that my house was burning down, and I had to decide between saving it and getting to my wedding on time, says Dan. I finally realized what it meant. I was afraid that getting married would mean I'd have to give up my privacy completely. I talked about it with Debbie. We agreed on ways we could each get time to ourselves. And the dreams stopped. Lovers and Author Strangers from CHFI.com. Lovers and Author Strangers from iTunes and CHFI.com. Edwin McCain, I'll Be All for One and I Can Love You Like That. And Simply Red, If You Don't Know Me By Now. Anytime we're about to make a major change in our lives, we're liable to agonize over the decision we're set to make. It isn't any wonder, then, why some of our anxieties manifest themselves in our dreams. If we can do as Dan did with Debbie, and that is discuss what we're feeling with the person who is also going to be affected by the changes we're about to make, then we're one step closer to stopping the dreams. You just might find he or she is also going through some of the same doubts you're having, and the mutual discussion just might bring the nightmares to an end. Lovers and Author Strangers from CHFI.com. Good night, sweet dreams. I'm Don Jackson.